Well, we're in for a wonderful evening of music. We have a beginning point. We're now past that. We have an end point. We have to meet that. And so we're going to move quickly into what you came here for, is to hear a lot of wonderful music. And I'm here to give you a lot of wonderful announcements. And one of those announcements is, this is the kickoff event of a whole weekend of activities. So I'm going to ask, are there people here who are just here for the concert? And if they're just here for the concert, could they stand up, please? All right. So look around you at the people who are standing up. Look around you at the people who are sitting down. This is a wonderful weekend of music. The music goes on for the next 48 hours, and you could be here for it simply by turning your concert ticket into a discount on your registration and joining us for Saturday and Sunday. We have wonderful events. There's song swaps, there are skill sharing workshops, there's a dramatic performance piece that's never been done before, there's a round robin sing, there are wonderful songs of the spirit on Sunday morning to lift you up, and you can be part of all that simply by registering during the intermission out in the lobby. And so please talk to the people that you saw sitting down. They can give you information on what the weekend is like. We would love to have you here for the entire weekend or for any part of it. You can register for Saturday, you can register for Sunday. Please come back and join us when the night is over. Okay. So we're going to start out tonight with Gloria Matlock and Michael Nix. They're people that I've had the opportunity to sing with because they're from here in Greenfield, and we were gathering on a pretty regular basis to sing songs in a circle of songs and storytelling, and they bring a wonderful spirit to the music, a great sense of history, as well as a great sense of harmony. They're going to be singing African-American spirituals for us tonight, and Gloria will also be doing a workshop on spirituals. I believe it's on Sunday, but definitely later on in the weekend. One more reason to register. Please welcome Gloria Matlock and Michael Nix.
Some people call it a banza, and there's been a lot of study of these things, and this is a reproduction of a painting of a banjo So that's what I'm doing.
So next song we're going to sing, it's a spiritual, it's called Lord, Search My Heart While I'm Down Here Praying. We did a lot of that.
Satan, we're gonna tear your kingdom.
welcoming the next performer. Maurice has been here before in performance on Friday nights and also doing workshops, as he will be doing again this weekend, Sunday morning, doing a workshop. And Maurice is a cultural activist, DJ, hip-hop artist from Holyoke, south of the tofu curtain, as they say in Northampton. And he's the East Coast Director of Hip Hop Congress, was a Bernie Sanders delegate. And a very active one. I know I've heard him speak at rallies. And please welcome Maurice Soulfighter King.
Give it up to PMN and all the hardworking people that made this possible. Now, I'm pretty sure we're all kind of pissed off at the political climate right now. Am I wrong? Am I wrong?
No!
But we're gonna get through it, right? So I'm just, can I get a paper and pen from somebody real quick, please? Paper and pen. But is there any people in this audience that like to be helpful? Anybody? Like one, two people? Three? Okay, all right. So I need someone that's like helpful. Anybody wanna help me out tonight, raise your hand? One, two, three, four, five. That's kind of crazy, man. There's like a million people, and three people want to help me out. All right, so to all that want to help me out, here's what I need y'all to do. There's this chorus that I have, and I need y'all to sing it. She's like, I'm glad I didn't raise my hand. And it goes like this. Take away the pain. Take away the pain. Hold on, time out. Y'all gotta hit it first. Take away the pain, take away the pain, take away the pain. Somebody's gotta come and take away the pain. Y'all got that?
Yeah.
All right, ready? Let's try it one time. Ready? Take away the pain, take away the pain. Take away the pain. Somebody's gotta come and take away the pain. All right, I want y'all to hold on to that real quick. So this next, what I need to do is I need to go around the crowd and get words from people. And then from that word, I'm gonna create a poem. All right? One word per person. If you don't know the definition of the word, don't give me that word, because I'm gonna be like, what does that mean if I don't know? And if you don't know it, you're gonna be like, ah. And you're gonna sit there looking weird, so don't be the weird person, all right? So who wants to give me a word?
Hate.
What?
Hate.
Hate?
Resistance.
Courage. Hold on, one person at a time.
Hope.
Wait. Some of y'all type 60 words per minute. I type maybe 13.
Justice.
I heard corporation. All right, I'm done. I heard a child down here. What did you say? Huh? Freedom. And what did you say?
Intersectionality.
Okay. All right, hold on, y'all. I only got a couple minutes, so. That's messed up. Alright, so the words y'all gave me was hate, resistance, justice, hope, collaboration, Trump, freedom, intersectionality. Cause I got personality. Alright. All around the world, people blaming Donald Trump, but I blame the system. Donald Trump to me is a manifestation of the system that was built on the death of the indigenous, built on the enslavement of Africans and the encampments of Asian people. We can point at him and one person and then we sleep on the rest of it, or we can say that Donald Trump is the spokesperson for all type of hatred. And we need to draw the lines to where they exist. And the only way that we're gonna defeat it is by bringing all those that are affected by all different types of oppression together. If not then there is no hope. But see, hope doesn't lie in righteousness, it lies in justice. There's a difference. And if we can find the intersectionality of all these things, only then can we create collaboration, create a path to freedom, because only then can love balance hate. Some say love trumps hate, but I look at the violence in the word Trump and I say, you can't get rid of violence with violence. Just like you cannot get rid of hate with silence. Hate, resistance, justice, hope, collaboration, Trump, freedom, intersectionality are all words until we put them in action. Those are the words you gave me, and that was the poem. Now, real quick, because I only got 3 more minutes. I got about 5 minutes left. So I'm going to do one verse to take away the pain. So all those that want to help me out, come on up. Y'all got to hurry up. Y'all got to hurry up. Come on. Come on. Y'all got to hurry up. Come on. Come on. Let's go. You got 10 seconds. 1, 2. Don't hurt yourself. Okay. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 10. Oh, she just made it. She just made it. All right, y'all. So we're going to do one verse to take away the pain, all right? Y'all ready? All right. So y'all, let me talk to my choir real quick, all right? So you guys, I want to introduce y'all to the PMN Choir. Give it up to the PMN Choir!
Take away the pain. Take away the pain. Take away the pain. Somebody's got to come and take away the pain.
I refuse to go back from where I came, the dirt and death, hate and shame. Seems like that's all I know, the pain that captivates my soul. See, I'm a bastard and emancipated slave from a self-hatred rage. Times I cry, pray the life gets easier. Keep my head up so I feel freer. I pray to God for salvation of earth, cause will it instrument my worth. Mom and dad never taught me this, but this vessel longing for the soul it missed. I miss confusion, economic storms. I meditate for flavor and strength to move on my experiences. I put on my rhymes to rock these slave ships and free our minds.
Take away the pain.
See, it's us that must
take away.
It's us that must free us and
take away the pain. Somebody's got to come and take away the pain.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Give it up for the people, man. Is that it? Damn. All right. Thank you all very much. I got 2 minutes, right? I got 2 minutes. All right, so y'all, very quick. Charlie King, right? I knew his name. I'll just see if y'all know. All right, Charlie King's going to help me out with this.
This land is your land. This land is my land.
from California to the New York Island.
If y'all know a saying, come on.
From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
One more time, Charlie.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island.
Come on, y'all.
From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me.
This land was here long before our parents got to you. And when we were born, we was fine, we was okay, we was full of love and curiosity until the programming took it all away. Now look at us fighting, look at us frustrated, look at us filled with a bunch of hatred. You got signs that says privatized property, look at people homeless, abandoned buildings. They call them eyesores. They have the broken glass theory to lock people up, people in jail. Homeless shelters, they fail because there's not enough of them. And they look at us and they see America, they see all the riches and wealth on television that belongs to the 1%, or the 99%, we're battling each other, we're frustrated. Some of us call for reparations, some of us says, no, I was not born then, that was my great-great-grandparents, but still, some of us say that you benefit from our oppression. But we still look at this and we still wonder, is this your land? Is this my land? Because if it's our land, then why don't we stand together?
As I went walking, I saw a sign there, and on the sign it said private property, but on the other side it didn't say nothing. That side was made for you.
But see, this side that we're on, this side has enough room for all of us to come together to creatively create hope. Built in our actions, not just our words, not just our meetings, not just our conversation, but in the sharing of food, and the sharing of resources. See, someone said to me that if you keep it, it withers away. But if you give it away, it will come back to you at the time that you need it the most. So while we're at that crossroad, while we're at that point in time where we must wonder, like Baker's Rebellion, like when they begin to create the laws for white people to live out the enslavement of the slaves that they were caught if they ran away with them, we have a choice. Do we continue struggling and fighting together at all costs? Or do we go our separate ways and all will be lost? And if we choose to stand and fight together, then we must fight on this land that is our land. Not my land, not your land, but the motherland that gave to us to build upon, to live upon as one human family. Come on, sing it if y'all know.
From California to New York Island, from Redwood Forest to the sea waters, this land was made for you and me.
Thank you very much.
Maurice, thank you.
The last 40 years of People's Music Weekend has been meeting, well, for most of the last 40 years, been meeting twice a year, once in the city, big cities like Greenfield. We do that every January, the last weekend of January. And then the first weekend in June, we gather at the summer camp. And for the last year, we gathered at a wonderful camp called Camp Kindleton in Tallinn, Massachusetts. We're gonna do that again this year. And so, if you're not on the mailing list for People's Music Weekend, try to get on that. You can drop your name at the registration table while you're signing up for the rest of the weekend. And put it on your calendar, first week in June, Camp Kindleland. Not only do we get to spend a weekend together singing, but also you get to sleep at the same place where you play. So that's a real advantage. Okay, so we're about to bring up two of the long-standing members of People's Music Network. And they have a near-perfect record of coming to these winter weekends. They did miss one weekend, but they had a perfect excuse. They were giving birth to twins. And I just realized this, the only time I ever missed a People's Music Weekend was when my daughter Nell was born. She was born first weekend in June, so there you go. They are children's performers. They also perform with adult audiences. They've just written a musical for kids, and they're going to perform the finale for it for us tonight. So please welcome Jenny and David Heidelberg.
Thank you. So we are so glad to be here, and it's always like being with our extended family, partly because so many of you did watch over our sons practically being born at a conference.
Yeah, their birthday is tomorrow.
Tomorrow they will be 22, if that helps anybody feel their age.
Yeah.
How's the guitar coming through? Is that there? Oh, there it is. Okay. So, Charlie did mention our new musical, and we're going to do that song second. But first, we're going to do something that is definitely not one of the things we do for children. And you know, there's a time for everything, right? There's a time for us to all hold hands and sing One World, One Love kind of things. And there's a time for resistance. And this is a time for both those things, of course. So this is a song of low blows and satire.
Yes.
And
we were really hoping to retire this song after the election season, but we've had to instead write some new verses.
Right. And Aileen Vance is the person who started this particular parody off, so credit to her, and then we kind of went with it our own direction. Feel free to join in once you get the hang of it. The Donald says that he was poor when he was just a lad. He swears he had a humble start and never was a cad. A small loan from his dad gave him a solid business plan. And now he swindles billions out of everyone he can. Oh, super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, ragged, atrocious. Even just the thought of him is something quite atrocious. He can yell it louder, but he'll never sound precocious. Super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Did you really need to vote for this guy? Did you really need to vote for this guy?
He thinks that just because he's male that it's okay to grope. Even if the woman very clearly tells him no. He's way he's talking, he should have his mouth washed out with soap. He thinks that we believe his lies, he must be high on dope.
Everybody! Super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Even just the thought of him is something quite atrocious. He can yell it louder, but he'll never sound precocious. Super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Did you really mean to vote for this guy? Did you really mean to vote for this guy? When he doesn't like the questions, he labels them attacks. He's got creative numbers and alternative facts. He's the biggest dictator, he'd like to crush dissent. He wants to be our emperor, not our president. Oh, super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Even just the thought of him is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough, you'll probably get psychosis. Super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Did you really mean to vote for this guy? Did you really mean to vote for this guy?
This flaming bag of Cheeto hair tells lies like they are gold. He rants and raves and sniffs and screams until we all go cold. As days go by, comparisons to him will start to grow. His tiny hands are clapping, looking like two side of gold.
Oh, super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Even just the thought of him is something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough, you'll probably get psychosis. Super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Did you really mean to vote for this guy? Did you really mean to vote for this guy? Well, we could laugh at what he says or what he told the crowd. But at day's end, we must be sure that he is not allowed to ruin everything and turn our world into a dump. He's the biggest turd we've ever heard. Let's all say no to Trump. Oh, super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious. Even just the thought of it is something quite atrocious. He can yell it louder, but he'll never sound precocious. Super callous, fragile, sexist, racist, braggadocious.
Thank you.
So we're just going to do one other song, which is the finale from our new musical for kids. The musical is called The World Is Not Your Garbage Can. It has kind of an environmental theme. And so this is the finale, and it's called We're All In This Together. Kind of an opposite feeling from that last song. And please
help. And I just want to say that we do a lot of work with kids, and they can help us keep our hope alive. You know, that's the way that we can really feel good about the future.
Yes, I give kids a hand. All we are saying is give kids a chance, I think that's it. So, yeah, actually just yesterday we were singing for a whole lot of kindergartners and we were doing Sally Rogers' great song, What Can One Little Person Do? And I'm looking at all those smiling faces singing out their hearts on that song, and I was just thinking, this is how we keep ourselves going, this is how we keep hope alive. So, this song, please join in once you get the hang of it.
City, where they work with an organization called Urban Art Beat. They are mentors with Urban Art Beat. I can attest to that because I have been mentored by them. I took a workshop in creative songwriting with them at the Great Labor Arts Exchange. They're very energetic, and they use culture to empower intersectionality. Would that be fair? Please welcome Dilson, Hernandez, and Ren.
How are y'all doing tonight? We're doing good? All right? Super glad to be here. Like Charlie King just said, we're part of Urban Artbeat, and we're here to bring you a little bit of some hip-hop flavor. So hope you guys take a test so we can excel. We all scholars, never forget about the dollar, but we got to holler and pop a collar, cause we fresh like that, we smooth like that. We got the power in our soul so we can groove like that. Let the track run,
and
track
then we gon' let the track run like.
Thank you so much.
There's no lying here, we're all confiding here. No fear, no fear, no fear.
No fear.
Do you hear me? Are you with me? Are these things that are gonna clear society? How we gonna heal, you and me?
Okay, sometimes the world gets a little cloudy, but it's okay. The rounds get a little rowdy. I meant the crowds. The crowds get a little rowdy. It's a riot out here. Donald Trump is president, so I guess we gotta stop and resist. Man, forget all that. Stop and frisk. I'm all about the peace, uplifting the people. Fist in the air. If you're feeling what I'm feeling, fist in the air. A fist in the air. Waving back and forth, show them that you care. Ayo, Ren. Ayo, Ren. So all we gotta do, so we can't always pretend.
There's power to the people. There's power to the people. Sing with me. Power to the people.
Power to the people.
Yeah, you know.
Power to the people.
Yeah, you know.
Power to the people.
There's many ways that you can flow. So you know,
power to the
people. Power, power, power.
Power to the people.
I said power, power, power.
Power to the people.
all these things without hesitation, cause we are all here to speak, and we say it and we're bold and meek. We're not shallow, we're really deep, and this is only the first day of the weekend. Man, I'm so happy and I'm red, and I'm your friend, so approach me again.
So power to the people,
power to the people.
Power to the people.
Said power to the people. Ignite the crowd so we can get the people in the steeple, or maybe the temple. Stay solid when I ride the instrumental. It's all mental. It's all mental. I never have it written in a page, so I can release my rage from this cage and manifest it. All these words that I put up on the stage. Yes. Sometimes, so we just let the light grow, let our soul grow like the crops in the earth. We gotta say it right, we gotta get right, so that we can get the turf. It's in our earth, Mother Earth, save her before she's gone.
Sing her song, sing it along.
Sing her song,
sing it along.
Sing it along. Sometimes I get down. Put your hands up if you feel it. Put your hands up if you feel it. Yeah, now it's time to get jiggy. Every time I spit my lyrics, I get silly. When I think of these urban, ebonic type linguistics, it's okay, I feel it in my spirit. I feel it in my spirit every time I spit these lyrics. It's okay, I can feel the essence.
Set the blessings.
Like I'm a seltzer, step a message, and I bet ya, you know what I mean, cause it'll leave you to me really.
It's okay, it's
alright. Are you with us tonight?
Yeah.
Can I get a power to the people? Can I get a power to the people?
Power to the people!
Beautiful, beautiful.
Well, there's a wonderful show ahead for y'all. We thank you. Power to the
people.
Who got the power?
People.
Thank you. Blessings.
Thank you, Dilson. Thank you, Ray. Our next performer is a very gifted songwriter and journalist. So why should I make up something about him? I'll just quote him. Evan Greer still passes for a young person by PMN standards, though she's been attending gatherings for more than 10 years. Evan is a radical queer activist, songwriter, and parent based in Boston. She's the campaign director of digital rights group Fight for the Future and writes regularly for The Guardian, Huffington Post, Time, and Newsweek. And I also, just extemporaneously, will say that Evan is doing as much as anyone I know right now to get the word out to as many people as possible, to get feet in the street at a time when popular resistance is our only hope. So please give a gratitude and welcome to all of you.
Thanks so much for being here. Who's excited for another PMN? I brought my kiddo with me this time. For those of you who've been following me around for a minute, you know that I'm leading a workshop tomorrow on how to make a living as a musician, which is ironic because I quit trying to make a living as a musician after I maxed out my third credit card. But in the brief interim period between when I thought I could make a living as a radical, transgender, anti-capitalist folk musician, and when I realized I needed to get a real job, I thought that there might be a strong niche market in radical, transgender, anti-capitalist children's music. So this was my attempt to add to that great canon. The only thing that people want to know about you is what's inside your diaper, should they buy you pink or blue? Well, all I care about is if it's pee or if it's poo, 'cause you're my little baby and I love you through and through. You can be a boy and a girl and a lion and a squirrel and a diamond and a pearl in the sea, or a big fat rock or an astronaut, but you just can't be a cop. True story. I'm gonna send this next song out because there's so much to be rageful about right now. But there's also so much hope. We stopped the Trans-Pacific Partnership. Despite he who shall take credit for all. But also, I'm gonna send this song out to a good friend of mine, someone who I speak to on the phone twice a week, but whose face I have still never seen. And her name is Chelsea Manning. She's gonna get out of jail the day before my birthday. Thanks to grassroots organizing. And this song goes out to all the mainstream gay rights organizations that never said a goddamn word in support of Chelsea Manning until President Obama commuted her sentence. And then they all tried to take credit for it, like Trump taking credit for us stopping the TPP. So here's my open letter to the mainstream gay rights movement in this country, which seems primarily interested in getting me married and into the military as quickly as possible. That was an inopportune moment to break a string. I think we'll get through it though. People ask me if I am a drag queen. I tell them I've never been into royalty. That's why I'm up in the pub yelling, Brits out of Ireland, Palestine free. If I had to choose, I'd be a drag peasant, organizing a rebellion, no time like the present. Glitter in my hair, pitchfork in the air, coming for those mainstream groups, I swear. If the gay nation wants assimilation, why picket fence Disney vacation? Joining in their military occupation, locking people up with hate crimes legislation, equal to the people who run the corporations. Living out in Brooklyn, gentrification. I say resist this elitist bullshit. I say it's time for a new movement. They're feeling this song, we can all sing along. I say queer, you say we're strong. Queer, we're strong. Queer,
we're strong.
Queer,
we're strong.
Have we waited too long to be sitting listening to politicians saying, hey, give you another inch if you give me another day. Have some patience, be a good gay. Just like FEMA with Katrina, they say help is on the way. But put your hands up if you're being lied to. Make some noise if your government is working for you. Check, 1, 2. I guess we got our answer, so what are we gonna do? Let's riot in the streets till the break of dawn. Start a revolution while we're getting it on. The laughter of our children will be our revenge. The only rings on our fingers are from self-defense. Don't ask me what I think, 'cause I tell you what I say. Said don't ask me what I think, 'cause I tell you what I'd say. We don't need gays in the military. We need militant gays! We don't need gays in the military. We need militant gays, I wanna hear ya! We don't need gays in the military. Thank y'all. If there were another guitar, it's like I'm in an ocean at PNN with everyone's like, do you want this brief for an unfurbished banjo? Let's see. Maybe there's a guitar coming. Maybe. Back there, anyone?
What do you need?
You want another guitar, maybe. That would be fantastic. We're looking for a guitar. We're looking for a guitar.
Yeah.
Is there a doctor in the house? While a potential guitarist coming, we're just pulling up the stage. I can play. That was a lot of work for one last song. Sorry about that, y'all. You got anything? We want to get through this the easy way, right? I'm used to playing just through a bullhorn anyway. Here's a song that I've been playing for too many years. It's called Ya Basta, which means enough already. If you feel that you've had enough, I invite you to yell Ya Basta with us during the chorus. If you feel like you haven't had enough and you'd like several hundred more years of white supremacist genocide, I invite you to remain silent. No one here will judge you. This is a very tolerant crowd, I can tell. Ya basta! Enough is enough. Ya basta! Enough is enough. Look at history. The cause of all our troubles, it's not a mystery. They're those whose lives are easy, they're those whose lives are rough. Now is the time for us to rise and cry out. Enough is enough! Greedy politicians, enough gender role traditions, enough hierarchies, enough of living on our knees, enough gouging of the planet, enough destruction of the earth, enough tearing of its flesh to see what the insides might be worth. We won't take it anymore. Oh, this is class war. We'll fight you in the streets. We won't dance on your defeat. This is your part. 1, 2, 3. Ya basta! There you go. Ya basta! Ya basta! Ya basta! Swear to you, there'll be a day when your melting pot will boil, and you all will bring us closer with each war you make for oil. Each union that you break and each ballot box you stuff brings us closer to the day we will cry out. Enough is enough! War and occupation, enough propaganda stations, enough enforced reality, enough police brutality, and enough nuclear arms, all enough factory farms, enough stolen women's choices, enough silenced women's voices. We won't take it anymore. Oh, this is class war. We'll will fight you in the streets. We will dance on your defeat. Young Basta! Young Basta! Young Basta! Young Basta! Because enough words have been said, enough songs have been sung, enough protests have been had, enough banners have been hung. We are many, but a few. There's so much we can do. We'll use what we have learned, fight them in our own terms. Because they need us, we don't need them. It's our sweat and labor on which they all depend. They need us to drive their trucks. They need us to shun their clowns. They need us to be the cops who beat our comrades down. But what good are all those laws? No one to institute them. What good are all those guns? There's no one there to shoot them. We won't take it anymore. Oh, this is class war. We'll fight you in the streets. We won't dance on your defeat. Young Basta! Young Basta! I wanna hear ya! Young Basta! One more time, come on! Young Basta! Thanks so much!
Evan Greer. See, the members of Amandla are gathering for their upcoming performance in a few minutes. We're going to share some information with you in just a minute. I know that you're here because you believe in the power of music to transform and empower us, and we're going to suggest to you ways in which you can do that, and I would suggest if you have a checkbook or a wallet that you loosen it up, because we'll be talking to you about that. But before we do, I'm going to ask Sue Kranz to come up and explain a little bit about how you connect with your housing if you're here for the weekend. Sue.
So, just to ease any of you who still have lingering anxiety about where you're going to be tonight, I would like all of the people here who are hosting to stand up. If you are hosting someone, that doesn't mean everybody who's hosting is here, but. So let's give them a round of applause for stepping up. Don't sit down here. Don't sit down. Okay, now if you, if you are a guest, can you please stand up? Your guest. So, yeah, let's hear it for the guests. So, if you have already met your match, that's great. Over in the corner where the registration was, there's a pink banner. That's the meetup table for guests and hosts to just make sure they know who each other is and that they've got a plan, at least until tomorrow. There may be folks that need rides, and maybe at that time, people can kind of figure out, if you don't have a ride, how you're gonna get to the gathering tomorrow in the morning. So I hope that things continue to unfold as smoothly as they have thus far.
I'd like to ask you to welcome Lucy Murphy to the stage.
Thank you,
a fundamental opportunity that we've been struggling with for 40 years is how to keep People's Music Network alive, viable, vibrant, and growing, and diversifying. And that's something we've struggled with just about from our inception. And Lucy has been one of the most active people in making that happen, or pushing us along in that direction, tugging us sometimes. We have an unusual opportunity this year. We received a generous grant from the Tiferet Fund to specifically to offer scholarships to people of color and youth to bring in more people from those sectors to enliven our membership and to enrich the culture of People's Music Network. So I know that it's going to be a lot easier to go back to those funders if we can say, you know, we matched your grant at the concert Friday night, and we'll continue to do that if you'll continue to fund us. So it's called the Matt Jones Scholarship Fund, and Lucy's going to give you a little reason on why it is the Matthew Jones Scholarship Fund.
Well, Matt Jones was a wonderful music teacher, singer, songwriter, who organized the second string, the most famous string of the SNCC Freedom Singers in the 60s. Matt, what can I say about Matt? He was a wonderful friend. He had a sense of himself which intimidated some white liberals, and who were more comfortable with people who were sick or undereducated, if they were people of color. And Matt understood that he was a citizen of the world, not just of this country, and that also intimidates some white liberals who want to limit people of color to the United States. He had a wonderful solidarity with the hunger strikers in Ireland, and we're going to sing a song about that called Long Kesh. He also had a wonderful, the reason why I met him is because he was a friend of Frederick Douglass Kirkpatrick, who came down to Washington to sing at a program where I sang for the Palestinian human rights. And then I went up to New York to sing with him at another rally and met Matt Jones. And then was introduced to the Open House Coffee House. Kirkpatrick had started the coffee house. I forget the name of it.
Hey Brother.
Oh, thank you. Hey Brother. And it continued after Kirk's death with Matt Jones. Every Martin Luther King holiday, for many years I went up to celebrate at the Open House Coffee House, where there would be members of the SNCC Freedom Singers, members of SNCC that would come and speak. Matt was into health. He actually trained women boxers. And he just had a wide range of, he was also an astrologer. He did my chart. But you know, the rough things are, is he saw people being assassinated. He himself was beaten in the arrest process in the South, in the Southern struggle. 29 times he was arrested. He was from North Carolina, but North Carolina and then some other places were not so friendly to him, so he ended up in New York City, which is where I met him. Matt, solidarity with the Palestinians gave us the song Palestine, which some of you hear me singing on Artists Against Apartheid, the website. And if you want more information about Matt Jones, just give me your information and I will, because I'm being limited by time here.
While we're singing, folks with some very colorful bags, want to hold them up? We'll be passing among you. And if you wanted to write a check, Ben, are you here? Would that be to the People's Music Network with memo the Matt Jones Scholarship Fund? So take your time.
Some of you are too young to remember the hunger strikers in Ireland at a place called Long Kesh. But they maintained their strike until they died. The British government didn't regard their lives enough to negotiate with them, and so they died. The St. Clair Bourne made a film called The Black and the Green about civil rights activists visiting Ireland, visiting the people who were struggling in Ireland, Sinn Féin and folks. That film exists, but who can find it? The Black and the Green, Sinclair Bourne, look for it. Because in it, the Irish in Ireland ask the black people who come visit them, why are the American Irish misbehaving and behaving so racist? Because we look to your civil rights movement. We're getting inspiration from you. I went down to Long Kesh to see Bobby Sands. He was not there, but his spirit keeps on living. I can see his shining face in the men and in the women and the children. They sang freedom songs. I went down to Atlanta. I went down to Atlanta
to see Martin King.
To see Martin King. He was not there, but his spirit keeps on living.
I can see his shining face.
I can see his shining face on the men and on the women and the children. And the children, they sang freedom songs.
Down to Mississippi.
I went down to Mississippi
to see Fannie Lou Hamer.
To see Fannie Lou Hamer. She was not there, but her spirit keeps on living. I can see her shining face on the men and on the women and the children. They sang freedom songs.
So I went over to India.
I went over to India to see Mahatma Gandhi. He was not there, but his spirit keeps on living. I can see his shining face on the men and on the women and the children. They sang freedom songs.
I went down to Long Kesh.
I went down to Long Kesh to see Bobby Sands. He was not there, but his spirit keeps on living. I can see his shining face on the men and on the women. Children, they sang freedom songs.
Thanks, Lucy. Lucy will be back as the MC for the second part of the evening. We will get to as soon as possible. Thank you very much for your generosity. We will add it all up and let you know during the second half of the show just what we collected for the Matthew Jones Scholarship Fund. Our next act is familiar to anyone who's spent time here in the Pioneer Valley. They've had a 29-year history. This week is their 29th anniversary as a chorus singing songs from all around the world, singing for peace and justice. I owe them a personal debt. It was 20 years ago that I did a concert with Amandla to raise money for a school in India. And 20 years ago, yeah, and I raided their membership and recruited one of their members. Her name was Karen Brandon. The rest is history. So thank you so much for that, and please welcome the Amandla Chorus. And this will be the last part of the first half, and then we'll talk about the intermission.
Thank you, Charlie.
Frederick Douglass said it. Those who profess to favor freedom but deprecate agitation are those who want crops without plowing the ground. Michelle taking a step forward to kick off a solo for a song I wrote years ago, having no idea how handy this song would come in.
Gender, profit, resource, crusade.
We're being called.
Amandla Quartz. Was that good? Well, truth is, we've been having a little bit too much fun here tonight, and we're running about 15 minutes behind schedule. We want to honor our commitment to the school. We want to also honor the need for sleep for people who are coming back early tomorrow morning. So we're going to cut the intermission ever so short. It's going to be a 10-minute intermission. You would not want to be the opening act for the second set, but you could be the most courteous audience member and be back in your seat in 10 minutes. A couple of things I want to tell you. You got a program when you came in, which was supported by local merchants. They put ads in there. Please hold on to that program, and please try to patronize those merchants. Tell them that you saw their name in the program. Thank them very much, and they'll be more willing to do that for us in the future. So I think I'm going to turn this over to Lucy Murphy, and we will see you back here. Look at your watches, or your cell phones, or your sundials. Please make a commitment to be back in your seat in 10 minutes. Oh, but before you get up, the most important thing. People donated their services tonight to sing for you. No one was paid to be here, but they do have recordings out on the table. So please try to, during the intermission, after the show, buy the CDs, buy the songbooks, buy the recordings. A lot of what you've heard is in Rise Again, the new songbook. So pick some of those things up, take them home, and that's a way of compensating musicians for the time they've donated. Have a wonderful intermission. See you back in 10 minutes. Oh, Ben, what is it?
Thank you, Marty.
9:15. Ben can do math.